We're getting ready to install the flare on the driver's side of this 144, and I get these questions a lot, so I just want to point out a couple things. Our flare is going to sit right above the slider rail, and this is where the door is going to come back. And the reason that we sell only the regular depth flare on this side is so that we can actually slide the door over the flare and not end up having any kind of bumps. The other thing that we do is we only sell the solid flares and the slider, the C.R. Lawrence slider window. That's so that you don't end up with an awning here, and then you open the door and you knock your awning off, and then you call me to ask why we are so dumb to put awning windows on the driver's side. So the other thing is, sometimes this van could have been a passenger van as opposed to a cargo van, which means this would have had a window on it. And the windows get taken off, but then there's adhesive here that you'll need to be able to remove before you install your flare. And the common way to do that is to use a 3M rubber wheel that goes onto a drill, and you just put a little elbow grease into it, and then you're able to basically rub that glue off, the adhesive off, or you can use a heat gun with a putty knife. But you want to be careful because you don't want to heat this edge up too much to distort it or to impact the paint in the surrounding area. So be careful, but it's no problem installing the flares where a factory window used to be. This is the OEM cutout, and it's the same whether you're going to cut it out because it's a crew or a cargo van, or if it came with glass.